So we are in the test class, which is called Fish Bash Test, and we are gonna throw the first test out there to be on that red stage we were talking before. So let's write one basic test function test number one returns one. Okay, so let's say we'll have a new class called fish bash. Okay, we are writing the test first so we can do wishful thinking, which means is, okay, how would I like my code to look like? How would I like my API to look like? So we just think is from the outside in, we say, okay, I want to have this class which is called, it's gonna be called fish bash. Why? Because we are doing the fish bash kata. So that makes sense. So we have that fish bash class, and then we say the result is gonna be when I call to this fish bash, by the way, I know why it's only wrote fish, and I pass, well, I call to a function called generate. Okay, so we want to generate the output. So it makes sense again for me. It makes sense to call it generate. So we'll call to generate, we'll pass the number, the input, and then it will return the output. Okay, on this case, because we are inputting one, it should say, it should return one. Okay, so let's set an assertion, assert equals. We expect a one there, so we set result should be a one. Okay, so we have the code. Let's run the test suite, and bam, it's failing. Okay, it's red, it's good, it was expected, and it's saying that the class test fish bash is not found. And that makes sense. That makes sense because we haven't even created that class yet. We only have the test class. So let's try to move to the next error or to green. So I'm gonna new file, I'm gonna create a new file which is gonna be on the source folder, and it's gonna be fishbash.php. Okay, let me do one thing. If I go to this and I move that here. Okay, we'll have here the test, and here I will write the fishbash class. Okay, so let me create the class. Namespace app. Good. And then we'll say class. Okay, and that's it. Now we have the class created. I could start writing the code for that class, but that's not what TDD is aiming for. Okay, so we have this, which is basically the error saying class not found. Okay, here you have the class. Let's move on. I run again the test, and still it's saying, hey, the test feedback class is not found. We have the class, so what could be that? In this case, it's because we didn't import the class fishbash. Okay, so let's import it, or the class app fishbash. So if we do that, basically it was fishbash on the test namespace because we didn't have this used. So now we've imported this. This class, when it says fishbash, is gonna go to app fishbash. Okay, let's run the test suite and see what happens if we move to another error. And yes, we do. So now saying that on our test is calling to a method called generate, but that method doesn't exist yet, which is good. You know, we didn't create it step by step, baby steps. Okay, so let's create that method. Public function generate. Okay. And you know, we could write the body, but step by step, baby steps. Okay, let me run this, and good. So now our test is expecting a one, but because we are not returning anything on that generate method, it's getting a null, which makes sense. Okay, here is gonna be the first weird thing you are gonna see. I'm sure you are thinking at this stage, okay, so we have here a number. No, we don't. So we are doing TDD, so we need to do baby steps, and we need to make the test pass with the minimum amount of code. Okay, so let's say I write return one without a parameter, without anything, and see what happens. So I run the test suite again, and help, it goes to green. Okay, and this is what I was meaning before with the minimum amount of code. You don't need to write the most complex solution at this stage. You just need to write what's the minimum to make all the tests. In this case, it's one, but that's the minimum amount of code we have to write to make this function make the test go to green. Okay, so now we are in the green phase because all the tests are on green. So we could refactor. We could refactor, and by adding this, that's not refactoring, that's changing the behavior. So if we now say number, that's changing the behavior, because so if we give the number 1, before it was returning 1, now it's going to be returning 1 as well. But before, if we were given 2, it would return 1, and now we are going to be returning 2. That's not refactor. Refactor is you change your code, but the output is always the same. You cannot change the behavior of your code. That's not refactoring. Refactoring is just changing the code to make it look better, nicer, but never changing the behavior. The input and the output should be all the time the same. So I will take this out. We are still on the refactor phase, and that's good. I don't have anything to refactor, so whoop, this was a 1. Let me run the. Okay, everything is on green. Good. So now we need to go again into the red phase, and I need to do a test which makes basically this fail, okay, and force us to write more code to make this hard-coded one go away. And for that, I'm gonna write, for example, public function. Let's test that the number 4, for example, returns 4, because it's not divisible by 3, neither by 5. So let me copy this code here. I will steal this, and I will say like this and that. I'm gonna be a 4. So now, again, we create a fishbash, we generate the 4, and we expect that 4 is gonna be the output. Let me run this and see what happened. And obviously, it's not giving us the 4 we were expecting, it's giving us a 1. Because we are hard coding it. Okay, that's good. So we were in red. Now we need to make the minimum amount of code to make these two tests go to green. Okay, so let's add that parameter. Okay, and let's say, okay, we are going to return a number now. And hopefully this will make the two tests go to green. Let's test that. And yes. It does. Okay, again, we've written the minimum amount of code, and now we have the two of the tests on green. So let's refactor. One thing I didn't add on here was the integer to the parameter. Now in PHP 7 we can add that, and I think it's a good practice to have all the your variables in control. So I say like it's gonna be an integer, and otherwise I don't want you to call to my function. So we add the integer, we are not changing the behavior, it's gonna be the same behavior, same input, same output. Okay, good. Now we are in green, then we refactor. Let's run and see that everything is still in green, which is very important. And yes, it is.